So today's workshop is on Yoga Nidra. How many of you have never practiced Yoga Nidra before? Yes, there are quite a few. So first, we will give little introduction, little theory behind Yoga Nidra, what it is. Because unlike other practices, once you start the practices, you can't break it, you can't speak. So I'll explain little bit. Then we'll have a nice Yoga Nidra to relax ourselves. It is a blissful relaxation. And then if you have any questions, the house will be open to question answer session. Is that okay, or you want something else? Fine. And when I'm speaking about Yoga Nidra, let it be a little interactive session. Okay, I'll ask you questions because some of you or many of you have already practiced Yoga Nidra, or you have been students in some of the yoga institutes, maybe Kaivalyadhama, maybe somewhere else, and you know about Yoga Nidra quite well. Yes, so please turn off your mobiles. Because once you start Yoga Nidra and then it goes to not permitted, it will have a bad effect on your consciousness, on your awareness, the disturbance. Okay, please make sure your mobiles are off. And your mind is switched off from external awareness. So what is Yoga Nidra? He rightly said it's not Nidra in yoga class. It is yogic Nidra, it's a sleep. Nidra means sleep. And the origin is from Lord Vishnu is always lying in Yoga Nidra on his seat of Sheshanag. He's always reclined and relaxing. But if the God goes to sleep, the world will come to stand still. I mean, it's just a joke. So, whether he really goes off to sleep or what does he do in Yoga Nidra? There is a sleep, he is relaxing, but he is aware. So it's a conscious relaxation. It's a practice of conscious relaxation where your awareness is withdrawn. It's a pratyahara practice. It's a relaxation practice. It goes into pratyahara stage, and if you go deep enough, if you can take your awareness deep enough, it can become dharana practice. So here the awareness is withdrawn from the external environment, brought to body. From body, it is taken within. So that's the pratyahara. But you are aware. And what happens in regular Nidra, regular sleep? What happens? You lose your awareness. You are relaxing. That's also relaxing. Yoga Nidra is also relaxing. What is the difference between two relaxation? With awareness, one other thing he just said. Same thing. He mentioned, as he introduced me, it's a total relaxation. There's a physical, in regular sleep, there's a physical relaxation. Body relaxes, muscles relax. But the mind is working most of the time. So you go off with one thought and you wake up with the same thought. So mind is still working and worrying. Maybe you can give her something, give a Swami Yoga Bhakti a mat here. So in Yoga Nidra, not only you are aware, but the relaxation is complete. It's a physical relaxation, it's a mental relaxation, and it's at emotional level also you let go. So you offload all your tensions, all your worries. Give her something if you And in Nidra, the tensions are still there with you. That's the major difference. In Yoga Nidra, what is the other characteristics? The awareness is not at conscious level. Awareness goes down into the subconscious level. We are not aware of many things. We are not aware of sounds outside. We are not aware of change in light or darkness. We are not aware of any sensation that our body is giving information about. But we are still aware. So we are aware of subconscious mind. What's happening in subconscious mind. So we touch upon, we have access, we have conscious access to subconscious mind, which doesn't happen in Nidra. Nidra is either you are conscious or you are asleep. But so Yoga Nidra is a transient phase between consciousness and deep sleep, kind of dream state. You can relate it with the dreaming state. But in dreaming state, you are conscious of something, but you have no control over it. In Yoga Nidra, you still have that control over that phase of your consciousness. So that's the difference between Nidra and Yoga Nidra. Clear? Just for Yoga Sadhak, all this is not needed. But I'm speaking also to cater to the need of students. And I'm sure there are quite a few students doing different yoga courses. So it's a little bit academic also and introductory also. So Yoga Nidra has how many stages? Those who have practiced? 8. Yoga Nidra has 8 stages. First is preparation. You get ready for Yoga Nidra. Then there is second stage of sankalpa or the resolve. What is sankalpa? Those who have practiced Yoga Nidra, have you gone through that stage? Because it's an optional stage. It's not always there. No. Sankalpa is some resolve you take. You decide something. Whatever you want to achieve, you take that as your sankalpa. I want to be completely healthy. Huh? So my sankalpa will be in a positive sentence and in present tense. Not I want to be. That means I'm telling myself I'm not healthy. It's a negative information goes into mind. So I'm telling myself in sankalpa, I am completely healthy. So when I repeat that sankalpa in all my Yoga Nidra practices, when my consciousness is deeper at subconscious level, subconscious mind level, then that seed is sown. And my mind will work on it and make it happen. Sounds like something great, but it is fact. You keep on repeating that resolve with your willpower and your full faith into the sankalpa, it always fructifies in the life. So you decide your sankalpa properly. Don't just take little small thing. Let me get a ticket of this. Which film is very hot now? Bajirao Mastani. Nobody's getting. I must get Bajirao Mastani film ticket today. Well, that's a foolish sankalpa to take. It will fructify. But you can't use a machine gun to kill an ant. Okay, so use your sankalpa. Decide, take your time to decide upon your sankalpa. Take it and repeat it till it fructifies. It's a very powerful tool of sankalpa. So that is the second stage and it's optional. Third stage is you take your awareness on different parts of the body. You will be guided. I'll be speaking and your awareness is linked with my voice and nowhere else. All the sensations are cut off except my voice. Only you will be aware of that. Okay? So that is rotation of awareness on body parts. That is third stage. That induces total physical relaxation beyond your imagination. In preparation, you do shavasana, you relax, but there is always some tension. But when you take your awareness on different parts, there is complete physical relaxation. Next stage is breath awareness. And that will relax your mind, because breath is linked to mind. So there will be total mental relaxation. And then in next stages, we'll talk about different sensation and different visualizations. There you go into your subconscious mind. You release your emotions. Whatever deep-seated good or bad impressions are there, they come to the level of your awareness and they are released. If they are good, bad impressions, some trauma which has happened in childhood or 1 week back or 1 hour back, it will come up. You will see it as a witness because you are not into that situation, and it gets released. So it cleanses the subconscious mind of all the traumas. Same way, it also releases the positive impressions. And we have knowledge of everything. Whatever is in cosmos is here. Yatha brahmande tatha pinde. We have knowledge of everything. But we can't access that knowledge. But in yoga nidra, at times, that comes up. And if something is bothering you, some problem, you will find that solution in yoga nidra. It will come up as a thought. It also happens in meditation. Yoga nidra is not the only practice. In meditation also you find solutions to your problems because you go deep into your subconscious. So this is what happens, cleansing of your subconscious mind, of your samskaras. So, and then there is reversal. You repeat your sankalpa and coming out of the yoga nidra. These are the 8 different stages. The key thing is not to fall asleep. Don't fall asleep. I'll remind periodically because it's a very narrow area your awareness is traveling. The journey is on very narrow road. You may go this side, become completely awake, or you can fall off to sleep. So try to stay in between. It will come with the practice. That's the key. And stay connected with the voice, mind today. Otherwise, if you are practicing with a CD or with some other teacher, that voice. Stay connected. That will help you stay awake. All the instructions need to be followed without using your intellect. Just do it. And doing is not moving your body. Your body is immobile. Nothing is moving. Everything you are doing with your mind and thoughts. Clear? For the people who are doing it for the first time, you are not moving at all. So, this is the basic introduction. We'll practice it, and then at the end of the practice, I may tell you the benefits. I have already told you few, but remaining ones. Okay? So, lie down with your head on this side. So, lying down in shavasana, your spine and head is in one straight line. Arms by the side of the body. Palms turned upwards towards the ceiling. feet apart, about a foot or foot and a half apart, toes turned outside. Close your eyes and gently close your mouth. Relax your whole body. Make your body very comfortable, because for another 30-40 minutes you are not going to move. So make whatever adjustment you want to make now. Quickly take your awareness from head to toes, and wherever there is tightness in the body, release that tightness, release that tension, and relax the body. Make sure your face is relaxed, the shoulders, the area between shoulder blades, release them. Both the arms are relaxed and the fingers are gently curled. The abdomen is relaxed, moving with the breath, gently up and down. The lower back is relaxed. Allow all the muscles of lower back to be relaxed. The thighs and the whole leg is relaxed. Both the legs are relaxed. The whole body is relaxed. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, allow your body to relax a little more. Deep breath in and let go of the body fully, as if you are surrendering the body to the floor. Don't hold on, just let go. Deep breath in and letting go, letting go. Take your awareness outside the body into the surrounding. Become aware of the surrounding of the room. If you are able to catch any sound, try to catch. Become aware of the sounds. Take your awareness far beyond this room, into the campus, into the gardens, beyond the campus. Try to catch the sound. And now back into the body. Bring your awareness back into the body. Become aware of the whole body. Awareness of the body lying on the floor. Awareness of all the contact points between the body and the floor. Wherever his body is touching the ground, be aware of it. Take your awareness within. Become aware of your breath, the natural breath. Normal, natural breath. The ingoing and the outgoing. And if you can become aware of your heartbeats, be aware of that too. The practice of Yoga Nidra now begins. If you have chosen your sankalpa, repeat it 3 times mentally with full faith and conviction. Sankalpa taken in Yoga Nidra never fails. I'm going to name some parts of the body. You will take your awareness into that part, visualize it, and repeat the name mentally. Do not move the body or any of the body parts. And do not fall asleep. Stay awake. Keep listening to my voice. Take your awareness on right hand thumb. Right hand thumb. First finger, second finger, third finger, fourth finger. All the fingers and thumb together. Palm of right hand, back of right hand, wrist, forearm, elbow, upper arm, armpit, right shoulder. Right side of the chest, right waist, right groin, right thigh, knee, shin, calf muscles, right ankle, heel, right foot, sole, big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe, all the 5 toes together. The whole of right half of your body. Become aware of the right half of your body. Stay awake. Keep listening to my voice. Take your awareness on left hand thumb. Left hand thumb, first finger, second finger, third finger, fourth finger. All the four fingers and thumb together. Palm, back of the hand, wrist, forearm, elbow, upper arm, armpit, shoulder. Left side of the chest, left side of the waist, groin, thigh, knee, shin, calf muscle, ankle, heel, left foot, sole of the foot, big toe, second toe, third toe, fourth toe, fifth toe. All the 5 toes together. The whole of left half of the body. Left half of the body. Bring your awareness on the back side of the body. Become aware of the right heel, left heel, right calf, left calf, back of the right thigh, back of the left thigh, right buttock, left buttock, lower back, upper back, area between the shoulder blades, back of the neck, whole of the spine, from tailbone to neck. right shoulder blade, left shoulder blade. Back of the right arm, back of the left arm. Back of the head, whole of the back side of your body, whole of back side of the body. Stay awake, don't fall asleep. Bring your awareness on top of your head, the crown, forehead, right eyebrow, left eyebrow, right eyelid, left eyelid, right eye, left eye, right cheek, left cheek, right ear, left ear, Brumadhyaya, the point between two eyebrows, bridge of the nose, the whole nose, tip of the nose, right nostril, left nostril, upper lip, lower lip, teeth, tongue, chin, jaw, front of the neck, front of the right chest, front of the left chest, the chest bone, upper abdomen, lower abdomen, navel, perineum, the whole of front of the body, the whole of front of the body, the whole of right leg. Become aware of the whole of right leg, whole of left leg, the left leg, the right arm, the right arm, left arm, left arm, whole of the back, whole of the back, whole of the front of your body, whole of the front of your body, right leg, left leg, right arm, left arm, back, head and face, chest, abdomen. Become aware of the whole body, whole body, whole body. Become aware of your breath, natural breath, the ingoing breath and the outgoing breath. I am breathing in and I am breathing out. Watch your breath, watch your breath, each and every breath. Don't fall asleep. Stay awake and listen to the instructions. Become aware of your breath and see your abdomen ballooning out as you breathe in. And as you breathe out, the abdomen becomes flat again. Breathing in, abdomen expands, the navel rises up, and breathing out, the abdomen comes down. Breathing in, abdomen rises, 7, breathing out, abdomen becomes flat, 7, count your breath from 7 to 0, breathing in, navel rises, 6, breathing out, navel falls down, 6, continue counting. Stay awake. Breathing in, abdomen fills up. Breathe in little more, allowing air to go into the chest. Breathing out, chest deflates and then abdomen deflates. Breathing in, abdomen balloons, then chest fills up. 7, breathing out, chest becomes empty and then abdomen becomes empty. 7. Count from 7 to 0 with each breath, breathing in, abdomen and chest. 6, breathing out, chest empty and then abdomen empty. 6. Count backward from 7 to 0. Don't fall asleep. And if you miss the count, start all over again from 7. As you breathe in, each and every pore of your body takes the air in. The whole body balloons out. And as you breathe out, the whole body contracts. The whole body is breathing in, ballooning out. And with exhalation, the body contracts. Breathing in, your body is getting filled up with air and ballooning out. And breathing out, the air comes out from each and every pore of your body and body contracts. Breathing in, the whole body becoming a balloon. 7, breathing out, body comes back to its size. 7. Count backward from 7 to 0 with each breath. Feel the body expanding and contracting. Stay awake. Come back to natural breath. Breathe naturally. Your breath entering the nose, going down into the chest, and coming out of the nose again. Natural breathing and awareness of the body. Become aware of whole body. Whole body lying on the floor. Feel, imagine and feel that your body is becoming heavy. Feel the body weight. It's becoming heavy and heavier and heavier. The pressure felt between the body and the ground is increasing as the body weight increases. Your body has become like a log of wood, very heavy, difficult to lift, difficult to move. Feel the heaviness of the body. It's extremely heavy. Let go of this sensation. Allow the body to become light. Your body has become very light, like a sponge, very light. There is no weight in your body. It can almost fly with a whisk of air. The body is extremely light, like a sponge. It can fly anywhere. Feel the lightness in the body. Feel the lightness. Awareness of natural body, normal body. You are lying on a hot iron plate and it is hot air is blowing. It is extremely hot. The temperature has gone from 32 to 40 degrees and now 50 degrees and 60 degrees. It's extremely hot environment, burning hot. Feel the burning on your skin. The whole body is hot. The environment is hot. Feel the heat. Feel the heat. And now hot environment has changed into cold. You are lying on the bar of ice, on the you are lying on the ice. You are almost lying on the snow-covered mountain top. Cold. And cold breeze is blowing. It's extremely cold. Extremely cold. Feel the cold. Right down to your bones. So cold. Feel it. Let go of the feeling of coldness. Become aware of the whole body. Become aware of the whole body, natural situation, normal body. Take your awareness at eyebrow center. Watch the space in front of your closed eyes. Watch the inner space of forehead, Chidakash. Become aware of the dark space in front of your closed eyes or inside your forehead. See what you see there, what comes up, observe it. don't fall asleep, stay awake. I'm going to take name of some objects or scenes. Visualize them in Chidakash, in front of your closed eyes. Visualize them as vividly as possible. Do not put in effort. Let the images appear spontaneously. You only imagine them and the image will appear. Do not strain. Feel all the sensations associated with that image. Burning candle. Burning candle. Burning candle. Endless desert. Endless desert. Endless desert. Egyptian pyramids. Egyptian pyramid. Egyptian pyramid. Torrential rain. Torrential rain. Torrential rain. Snow-capped mountain. Snow-capped mountains. Snow-capped mountains. Temple at sunrise. Temple at sunrise. Temple at sunrise. Coffin beside a grave. Coffin beside a grave. Coffin beside a grave. Birds flying across the sunset. Birds flying across the sunset. Birds flying across a sunset. Drifting red clouds. Drifting red clouds. Drifting red clouds. Cross above a church. Cross above a church. Cross above a church. Stars at night. Stars at night. Stars at night. Full moon. Full moon. Full moon. Smiling Buddha. Smiling Buddha. Smiling Buddha. Wind from the sea. Wind from the sea. Wind from the sea. Waves breaking on a deserted beach. Waves breaking on a deserted beach. Waves breaking on a deserted beach. Restless sea. Restless sea. Restless sea. Stay connected with your Chidakash, the inner space in front of your closed eyes. Observe any experience if you have. Observe it as a witness. See see yourself sitting in meditation asana, Echidakash. And you see yourself chanting Omkar. Feel the vibrations of Omkar at eyebrow center. Mentally chant long Oms. And feel the vibration at eyebrow center. Let go of Om chanting. Repeat your resolve, repeat your sankalpa 3 times mentally with full conviction and faith. Become aware of the body. Become aware of the body. The body lying on the floor. Feel the contact points between the body and the floor. Become aware of your breath. Become aware of your breath. Awareness of heartbeat. Awareness of various sensations arising from the body. Touch of the clothing. Touch of floor. Awareness of various body parts of the head, of the arms, of the legs, of the trunk. Become aware of individual areas of the body. Become aware of the people practicing yoga nidra around you. The practice of yoga nidra has now ended. Start bringing out your awareness. Become aware of the people around you. Become aware of the hall, the walls, the door, the windows. Take your awareness beyond the hall, outside. Listen to the sounds. Think of the trees around, the gardens, other buildings, the path. Listen to the sounds. Bring the awareness back from external environment into the room and into the body. And if you have become fully conscious, start moving your toes and fingers. Ankles and wrist. Move your head side to side. Bend your knees and elbows and make them straight. Start awakening all the muscles, make them active. Clasp your fingers and stretch your whole body. Full stretch and relax. Twist your body, bend your knees, and bent knees, bring them on right side and face on the left side with fingers, clasped fingers behind your head or neck. And twist other way. Twist the whole spine this way and that way, couple of times. And when your whole body is awake, muscles are active, your consciousness is fully alert, keeping the eyes closed, turn on one side and sit up facing me. Then rub, once you are sit up, then rub your palms together, make them warm. Put them over closed eyes. Allow the warmth to pass to the eyes. Blink a couple of times under the cover of the palms and then open them. Remove the hands. Hari Om, that's it. The practice of Yoga Nidra is finished. And now we can switch on the lights. So how many of you fell asleep? Very few. So I must give you credit. I always sleep. So you are a good yoga practitioner. Very nice. And I'll cross check how much you have experienced. So what sensations were felt, different sensations? Who's going to tell me? Okay. Heavy. No, I asked you to feel different sensations. So what were they?
Heat and cold.
Light and heaviness, yes. Yes, you are right that the body became heavy because of extreme muscular relaxation. The body becomes heavy. Like, the name is Shavasana, no? Shava, the dead body, is heavy because there is total relaxation. It is so heavy to carry. Just like that. If you do Shavasana 100%, normal Shavasana is never so much relaxation. But in Yoga Nidra, the muscular relaxation is so much that body really feels heavy, and at times you want to move. Suppose a fly is sitting or a mosquito is biting, you are not able to move it because it's so heavy. You had it all through?
Yes.
Was it bothering you? It was pleasant. So tingling sensation in Yoga Nidra is because of two reasons. One is the pranic movement you are feeling, because your consciousness, your awareness has become so sharp that you are able to feel the pranic movement. And second is that you are awake and you are uncomfortable, and the thing, because of, you know, when you are sitting cross-legged for some time, the leg goes off to sleep, something like that. That sensation of tingling can also happen then you are very conscious. You are not, you have not gone inside in yoga nidra. Also, you can feel that. Any other experience? Yes, because we are not used to. And because our right brain is not active, which has the ability to visualize. Children have that ability. And then as they become older, they become conditioned into the left brain thinking and learning and using only left brain. So after childhood, when we get into adulthood, slowly, slowly, we lose that ability to visualize. And that is why yoga nidra should be, should be used to retrieve that ability to visualize, to reactivate our right brain. And when we reactivate that right brain, I was to discuss that. Why visualization? Why it is important? Because when we start visualizing, we activate that skill, our creativity gets manifested. It is there, but we can't access it. But once we start right brain learning, the creativity manifests, the ability to intuitive knowledge or learning through imbibing, not by visual and auditory medium, not someone has taught or we have read and we have learned, but just imbibing knowledge, which children do. If you attended Garbha Sanskar presentation, the child in the womb is imbibing everything.
It is possible to activate at the older age?
Yes, yes, at any age. No age is old age. No age is old age, right? No age is old age. You can do everything.
Violet and green color with orange petal.
Yes, you saw that.
Yeah.
Very nice. So, violet represents spirituality. So different colors have different meanings. We won't go into that detail. And we should not even put our mind to it. What does it mean, what I saw? Something got manifested from subconscious. And it is dealt with. If it repeatedly comes, then you have to find out what it is. So don't worry, just be witness of what you see in inner space. When the time gap is there, when no instruction is given, something will come up. Also when the instructions are given about see moon, maybe something which happened in full moon day will trigger and come up. Not that every time everything comes up. It comes up once in a while, but then it shows you the direction. Either it solves your problem or it shows the direction how you should go. So you had good experiences. Nice.
Any difficulty? Whether it is possible, it becomes difficult with self-instructions.
No, you should not be practicing with self-instruction. Because then you are remaining alert. You don't go into that level of consciousness within. So either do it with a teacher or a recorded practice. Yes, behavioral patterns can be altered. If some conditioning is holding a person, like trauma, etc., it is released and the behavior changes. One, also with sankalpa you can change the behavior. So it is used for as a behavior therapy. And very trained, highly trained yoga teachers, not all yoga teachers, but very highly trained yoga teachers, they know which visualizations to give, which symbols to give, depending on the history of that person. Suppose the child had a car accident where he lost mother or whatever, or may not have lost anybody, but you know about that incident and you can give appropriate visualization to heal that trauma. Post-war trauma sufferers, yoga nidra helps them change their fear and other behavior patterns.
Can we keep multiple sankalpas or only one we should focus on?
Take one sankalpa and keep it steady till you realize that sankalpa. Not complicated one, just one simple sentence. Yoga Nidra is also very useful for learning. So what is done, of course, again, a very qualified teacher should do it, not everybody should do it, is that you take a person into Yoga Nidra, and at certain stage, say visualization stage, you read out particular language. Say, I want to learn French. So French is read out. Or I want to learn Bhagavad Gita by heart or understand it. So Bhagavad Gita is chanted. And then when I come out of Yoga Nidra, not immediately, maybe next day, I read Bhagavad Gita. I read French portion that was read out. And then the learning becomes quick. Because the process of learning is best, the receptivity is best when we are relaxed. That is what yoga in school is all about. Why we want to relax the children? Because their receptivity, their learning ability improves. So Yoga Nidra, also even if you don't read out any passages, anything, you give Yoga Nidra or a short form of Yoga Nidra, relax themselves, relax the kids, and then teach. Or you can even relax with awareness of breath. 2 minutes of breath awareness, and children are relaxed. Brahmari, they are relaxed. And then a lesson starts, a class on science or math starts. So then their ability to receive that knowledge is more. So Yoga Nidra is also used for that. And if you remember, someone was talking about the flow and creativity, I think in today morning session. So creativity improves, the research on musicians, when they get into the flow. So that the phenomenon of flow happens with conscious relaxation, with Yoga Nidra. So it's, Yoga Nidra is very useful for students and for artists or for people into creative activity, poets and everyone.
How frequently should it be practiced and what are the contraindications?
How often we should practice? One can practice it every day. Very good if you have time of half an hour to 25 minutes. Yes, one should practice every day. The best time, there are few best times depending on what is the purpose of Yoga Nidra. If you are an artist or a student, you may do Yoga Nidra in the morning before you start your working day. But for stress management, like for better relaxation, it is done at the end of the working day in the evening, before dinner. For people who are not able to sleep well, insomnia, they may do it, of course, for stress release so that sleep can be better. But also just before sleep, they do it, and not with the sankalpa that I will not sleep. They should not repeat that I'm not going to sleep, I'll stay awake, no. But use Yoga Nidra to fall asleep. If student want to have less sleep, exam is very close, appearing for entrance exam of medical or MBA or whatever, I can't afford to sleep 5, 6, 7 hours. So they do Yoga Nidra, and say 1 hour, not 1 hour, but say half an hour of Yoga Nidra can cut down a requirement of sleep by 2 to 3 hours. So they can sleep only 4 hours and practice Yoga Nidra half an hour, 45 minutes. So they are saving on a couple of hours of sleep, which they can use in study. So depending on what is your need, the time of Yoga Nidra changes. But everyone is not able to find so much time every day. So over weekend, if you do it, also it is good. If there is not particular aim, I want to do this now, then you can do, normal people can do over weekends. Yes.
A person crosses the limit of awareness into sleep, is there any harm? Are there any contraindications?
One second. So if people fall asleep in yoga nidra anyhow, no, there is no harm. Because you still take things in, but the benefits are not so much. They are reduced. The quantity of benefits gets reduced. There are absolutely no contraindication unless a person is very depressed and withdrawn and in a, sitting in a corner, no activity. We want to stimulate that person and relax further. But those are rare cases. Otherwise, everyone can. For healing of psychosomatic, yes, that part. So in yoga nidra, there is a lot of parasympathetic activity. And see, sympathetic activity is needed. It's not only stress, but it is needed for everyday living, to face the world. But we also need parasympathetic activity to relax, to rejuvenate, and to heal. Our digestion happens when there is parasympathetic activity. Our healing, wherever trauma or wherever diseases are there, happens when there is parasympathetic. So yoga nidra, that way helps healing and rejuvenating our body. So that is another use, therapy. In hypertension, in any psychosomatic disorders, yoga nidra helps medicine to act better.
Savasana and yoga nidra same? Savasana and yoga nidra same?
Shavasana is newborn baby and yoga nidra is fully grown adult.
Main difference?
Shavasana is very superficial relaxation. Huh? Less than even nidra, less than normal sleep. Yoga nidra is intense. And it has many other benefits which I have been talking in the last 1 hour. Shavasana, no, it relaxes. It helps you. Only benefit of shavasana over yoga nidra is it is short. So when you don't have time, you do shavasana. And when you have enough time, you do yoga nidra.
Shavasana can be self-instruction. But
yes,
yoga nidra can
be.
Minimum age to
start yoga nidra. See, children are basically restless and you can't give full-fledged yoga nidra to children. They are modified. They are very, it's kind of extended shavasana and visualization. That's it. But they should be given visualization and even age of maybe 8 or even earlier, yoga nidra can be given. Yes, young children, maybe 6, 7, 8. 8, definitely you can start yoga nidra, but it is not a conventional yoga nidra. They have little longer shavasana. Rotation is big parts, arm and leg and some tummy and like that, quick. And then lot of visualization, because they are very good at it. And you want to keep that ability alive all through their life. You don't want to let that ability die. So visualization. And give them teachings also. And they love to have story visualization, you know. You can take them on the boat ride or on the space and things like that. Like fairy tales. Depending on the age of the child.
Is yoga nidra a meditation?
It can go up to dharana practice, which I tried today, little bit. Om chanting and feeling that. It was very short, but yes. It's not a meditation, it's a mainly pratyahara practice. But it can go up to dharana, when you are intensely aware of breath. And we can give, say, ajapa japa breathing and things like that can be given. It can be stretched into dharana practice. But in dharana, one has to be more conscious. Huh? That's the... So that way it is never a dharana. Because there is awareness, there is consciousness, but it is not consciousness. It's not alert consciousness. But in dharana, that is required. So it's not 100% dharana, but one pointed concentration does happen.
Any rule to structure your resolve?
Rule to structure the resolve, it has to be very simple sentence in present tense. And it should not be harming to others. It should be a positive sentence for self.
Oh,
it's better to take your sankalpa for yourself, others should take a sankalpa for themselves. Yeah, you should not be taking sankalpa that boy is having first rank and I'm having 10th rank, so I want to have, he should go down and I should come to first rank. No, you can say I will do my best. I will do my best. You are not, because then if there is any negative element, even indirect, it will boomerang on you. Because it's very powerful, the sankalpa.
Will not become angry, but not smoke.
It is better I'm always happy and calm. So the angry part is taken care of. So rather than taking I will never be angry, say I will always be happy, calm and contented.
From where we can get the CDs recorded
one? Where are you from? Delhi. Maybe you write to Munger Ashram, Gangadarshan Ashram. Probably there is Shivanand Society in Delhi. They definitely sell our publication, but I'm not sure about CD, whether they sell CD or not. They are our sole selling agent for national and international needs in Delhi. But I'm not 100% about CD. So better write to Ashram and find out. Mumbai Satyanand Yoga Center used to sell, but now currently I'm not sure whether they are selling. I can give you a number, phone number afterwards. I'll find out the phone number and tell you, and you can inquire with that person.
How long should be?
How long?
How much short or long should be the resolve?
Resolve. No. Well, you don't keep if and or and extend the sentence for the whole page. One simple sentence can be one or two lines maximum. Because if you make it very complicated, see, the subconscious is not intellectual, that is intuitive. Let's do Shantipat. And this Shantipat, probably you know, it's little longer, but many of you will be familiar with it. You do it with full bow. So I'm going to explain the words and do it with that bow. And if possible, every day night before going to sleep, you should do that for your well-being and for the well-being of everyone in the universe. The first three lines are prayers for your own self. Asato ma satgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityorma amrutam gamaya. Most of you know the meaning. I will still tell in brief. Asato ma satgamaya means from untruth, lead me to the truth. Asato ma satgamaya. Tamaso ma, tamas is darkness, ignorance. From that you take me to light or the knowledge. And mrityu is not bodily death, but from destruction you take me to the creation. So that is the prayer for one own self. Then comes prayer for others. Sarvesham swastir bhavatu, sarvesham shantir bhavatu, sarvesham purnam bhavatu, sarvesham mangalam bhavatu. And lokaha samasta sukhino bhavantu. It is very easy. Sarvesham means to all, swasti is auspicious, shanti is peace, purnam is completeness, and mangalam is everything should be good with them. So specially you think about person whom you have little difference of opinion that day. Huh? So, and you pray. And you pray for your family and for your friends and for your loved ones, everybody. But definitely for that person, so that before the day ends, you resolve all the conflicts from your mind. And sarvesham loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Everybody should be happy, sukhi. Then comes Mahamrityunjaya mantra, which is again, you do it for the whole well-being of the whole universe. Peace, prosperity and plenty for all, everybody. Everybody does not mean human beings, but for all living beings. And then, again, no. Then you think of your Ishta, your most beloved one. Maybe it's your Guru. Maybe it's Krishna or Shiva or Jesus Christ or Buddha or Mahavir Prabhu, whoever is your Ishta, whoever you worship in your heart, whomever you want to connect. Think of him and say, Tameva Mata Chapita Tvameva, you are my mother, you are my father, Tvameva Bandhu Sakha Tvameva, you are my brother and the friend. Tvameva Vidya, you are my knowledge. Dravinam Tvameva, you are my wealth. Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva, you are everything to me. So you are saying thank you to your Ishta. Okay, so with this bhav, we do it now. And if possible, you do it every night before you go to bed. So, sitting quietly, comfortably, both hands on the knees, with first finger touching the root of the thumb, Gyan or Chin Mudra, eyes gently closed, body relaxed and erect. For a few moments, become aware of the whole body. And then become aware of your breath. Take your awareness to eyebrow center. Visualize or imagine a bright flame, jyoti, divine flame, or any other symbol of your meditation which you have chosen already before. Keeping the symbol of jyoti or your own meditation symbol, asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyoti Yorma Amritam Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanat Mrityor Yamamrutat Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. Pranam Mudra. Become aware of your Ishtadev at eyebrow center. Tvameva Mata Chapita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhusha Sakha Tvameva Tvameva Vidya Dravinam Tvameva Tvameva deva sarvam mama deva deva twameva sarvam mama deva deva hari om. Bring your hands down. Allow the image of Ishtadev and Jyoti flame disperse. Become aware of your whole body. Become aware of the state of your mind. Feel the peace and love for your own self and for others. And now, rub your palms together, bring them warm, bring them to your closed eyes. Blink the eyes a couple of times, open them, remove the hands. Hari Om, that's it. So, that's it, it was nice.